in November in 1978, 2,671 units of these Nugent pinball machines came off the assembly line over at Stern. The game design was by Mike Cuban. The game featured his Weekend Warriors album cover on the back glass. Ted Nugent was a huge deal back in the late 70s. He sold 40 million albums worldwide. His first three albums were certified platinum. He's a bona fide guitar god. He's right up there with the likes of Jimi Hendrix and Eddie Van Halen. He's known for shredding with heavy duty power his Gibson guitar. Because of the low production numbers on this game, fully restored, the value is unknown because it also has a dual market. It's a heavy piece of rock and roll memorabilia and a huge trophy for anybody that collects rock and roll stuff.
The first rock pinball machine I remember is Nugent. How did this come about with you being on a pinball machine?
I don't know. I think the world heard my music and they were so confused with what to do with the energy that they knew that somehow they had to legally find a way to play with my balls every night.
This game, it's got chrome plating, it's got the CPR limited edition playfield. Only 20 of these playfields were made. One of the cool features about this game is it has added sound features. Back in the day, this was basically one of the first games to have electronic sounds, and it has the SP100 soundboards, and the sounds are really inferior. It just sounds like little R2-D2 noises. And the problem with this game, since it was the first, you know, theme license or rock theme license game, was that you really didn't get the Ted Nugent experience. Because, I mean, all it played just like all the other games, but all it only had a picture of the album cover on it that made it different. So that's not really the Ted Nugent experience. So welcome to 2024. And we updated this a little bit. It plays all of the original factory sounds, plus it plays all of these Ted Nugent tracks in the background. Let me give you a little demonstration.
So what it does is it has all of the regular factory sounds. Plus, it plays all of these songs in a loop.
See, it's pretty fun.